हाय, हेलो, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन. वेलकम टू ग्रेड अप. वेलकम टू द सेशन नीलिट 2020. आई एम सत्या, वेटिंग फॉर यू ऑल टू जॉइन द सेशन. सो क्विकली जॉइन द सेशन एंड मार्क यूअर प्रेजेंस. ऑल्सो प्लीज कंफर्म, एम आई विजिबल टू यू एंड एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू प्रॉपरली और नॉट. आई कैन सी Pragan, Manoj, Pratap already joined the session. Good evening, guys. So, all the students, please mark your presence. And please confirm, am I visible to you and am I audible to you properly? Midhun Kumar, Ankit Jain, Jashwant, good evening. Ravikant, good evening. Krishna Gopal, Harshal, good evening. So today we will discuss about cache mapping techniques. Whereas in the last class we have discussed about secondary storage. If you remember, the last technical session happened in which we have discussed secondary storage, and today we will be discussing cache mapping techniques. Okay, Vandana Pal, good evening. Kushbu Tiwari, good evening. Abhishek Verma, hi. Charu, good evening. Ankit Jain, yes, you can attend because it is an independent class. Today, whatever is happening, it is independent of the previous sessions. Okay? So before we go for technical part, it's a request for everybody to wash your hands frequently as guided here to protect yourself and others against infections. And for any corona related support, you may reach on this toll free number 9111-239-78046. So guys, prep smart and stay safe. This is me, Satyanarayana. I'm a PhD scholar with 13 plus years of teaching experience and with all other credentials. Gaurav Kumar, expected date of exam maybe in the July last week or August. That is expected currently, but if the lockdown period extends, that may extend again. Okay, so guys, what is basically a cache memory? To understand cache mapping techniques, what is basically cache memory, guys? It is the interface between primary memory, that is main memory or RAM we can say, and processor. So between processor and RAM, cache acts as an interface. Why? Because RAM is slow compared with processor. So there is much speed gap between RAM and processor. Mm-hmm. But will cache memory work at processor speed means cache work only at half of the processor speed? So compared with primary memory, cache memory works 10 times faster, but compared with processor it is at half of the processor speed. So to balance the speed gap between RAM and processor, cache is needed. In other words, we can say to reduce CPU waiting time, cache is needed. Why cache memory is named as so means, caching means prefetching. So cache predict what may be requested by the processor in future, how it will predict based on locality of reference principle. This principle says that if some data is accessed currently, same data may be accessed again, or nearby data may be accessed again. So based on this principle, cache memory predict and fetch that before CPU request. So before CPU requested only, cache memory load such content. That's why this is named as so. Now whenever CPU requests a content, both cache memory and RAM try to fulfill this request. So if any memory or if a memory could supply that is said to be hit, otherwise that is said to be miss, right? Now for RAM and cache, when both are trying to supply, as cache is faster, if cache has the content, cache will generate hit, right? So for cache it is hit means for RAM it would be miss. So the performance of cache memory is measured in terms of hit ratio, that is number of hits by total number of requests. Vinay Kumar, the next class would be DMA. Okay. Now, when the hit ratio is H, miss ratio is M, what would be miss ratio? Miss ratio would be always 1 minus hit ratio. Right? Because if 100 requests are made by the processor, 70 requests are supplied by cache, then we can say 0.7 is hit ratio. That means remaining 30 are misses. So 0.3 would be miss ratio. Simple, right? Now, what is mapping means? Whenever CPU request any data for the first time, definitely it will not be in the cache. So what occurs? Miss occurs. When miss occurs, cache memory locality of reference principle initiated. So what it will do? It will bring that data and nearby data. Here nearby means, you have to understand, nearby means cache and RAM both will be partitioned into blocks, and blocks are further partitioned into words. So if this is the block, it will consist of many words. So here, if any word is requested out of the same block for the first time, any word requested out of the block for the first time, then all the block is copied. So from cache to RAM, from RAM to cache, how much gets transferred? One block gets transferred at a time because of locality of reference. So whenever any data gets transferred from one memory to another memory, address translation also happens. Address also gets translated. Right. This address translation is what we call as mapping technique. This process of address translation is what we call as mapping technique. Okay. Now, there is another name for the mapping technique, that is called placement policy. What is this mapping? When this mapping happens? Whenever data transfer from RAM to cache. Right? Suppose this is the cache memory. These are all the blocks. All are free blocks. Now there is a RAM. These are all the blocks. Now, these are the words. Suppose a word X is requested. Let word X is requested, which is from, let's say, block 3. So total block gets transferred from RAM to cache memory, right? Because RAM to cache, how much gets transferred? One block gets transferred. Now the question is, in these all free blocks, in which free block this would be copied? Now, where in cache memory it is copied? This is the question. Will it be placed in the same block 3 or block 1 or block 7? So where it will be placed? All are free. So where it is placed, how the placement happens? Whenever placement happens, address translation happens. That's why mapping techniques and placement policy both are related to each other. Basically, there are three types of mapping techniques. They are direct mapping, associative mapping, and set associative mapping. What are they? Direct, associative, set associative. Guys, is this disturbance there for everybody or only for Pantage? Sorry, for RD Patanj. Rahul Bansal, good evening. Gurpreet Singh, did anyone contacted you? Are you taking a NEELIT course, Gurpreet? Guys, could you please answer? Is noise there for everybody? Will everybody? Okay. So RD, could you please close it and reopen it again? Great. Thank you. Thanks for the response. So Abhishek Verma. Abhishek Verma, please understand. Currently, this is the block which is getting copied. Right? Now, when it is copied into, when it is copied into cache memory, there are many free blocks. So, where it is copied? Is it copied here or here or here? So where it is placed, how the place for a block is decided, that is called placement policy. Okay. Nallamalu Satish. Mapping is the general term which is used for address translation. That can be physical address, virtual address, logical address, cache memory address, you give any name for those addresses. Address translation is called mapping. Here, that's why we are prefixing this mapping with cache mapping. We are prefixing this mapping term with cache. So here it is understood, RAM address to cache address. Here we are translating. Okay. Okay, that's great, Gurpreet. That is good. Good to hear. Sai, the page that you talk about, virtual memory is different. Here, page is different. Okay. Manoj Upadhyaya, if you hold for a while, I will explain. That will come. Okay. Guys, before we move ahead, these are the classes, free classes happening for CS students. That is, at every weekday 3 p.m. concept on fingertips class will happen. That is on GradeUp app. And in the YouTube at 5 p.m. our class will be there from Monday to Thursday, technical. And at 7 p.m. for GATE aspirants, another free class will happen on YouTube. So please try to share this information as much as possible and let many people benefit out of it. Right? Now, what is direct mapping? What is direct mapping? Please see, look at this. Suppose there is a RAM. So here we have a RAM. Let's say this is of 256 megabyte RAM. Let's say one block size is equal to 1 megabyte and there are 8 words per block. Okay. Prajwal Kumar, in the free series, we will teach not all the subjects. So, it may not be sufficient, but that will be value added for you. Maybe in June, we will be launching the paid course for GATE. You may be interested in that. Till then, you can enjoy the free classes. Okay. Kanishka, concept on fingertips classes started almost 2 weeks ago and it is successfully happening. So you can attend that class also. Sai, we are with computer organization subject. Here, nowhere we will take the term process. Nowhere we take the term process. So, page, paging concept is nowhere related here. That comes in operating system, virtual memory topic, because there also mapping techniques are there. As Nallamalu Satish was telling, physical address, virtual address, all that concept. So don't relate that here. Okay. Guys, before I go ahead, please, as your elder brother, let me give you a suggestion. You might have watched it in the Jackie Chan movie also, Karate Kid movie also. I liked that scene very much. Generally, I will share this in many of my sessions. When we are intensed to learn something, we have to learn it with an empty mind. So when your bowl is full, whatever anybody pour, that gets overflow. So your vessel, your mind vessel should be empty, then only you can gain or you can understand the things at a very transparent, without any confusion. So it is just a suggestion. I am not degrading anybody here. If anybody are getting hurted, I am very sorry. Just as an elder brother, I am telling, anywhere, anytime when you are learning something, don't take whatever you know into mind. Just feel like you don't know that and you are learning that. Because if you complete that particular topic learning, whenever you gain the knowledge, then you can easily relate what is what. Okay? Rahul Bansal, green card will give you all mock tests, including nail it. ISRO mock test, BARC mock test, GATE mock test, all, whatever the mock test that we launch, all mock tests you can get in that period, whatever the green card you take, 3 months or what, 1 year membership. So that would be useful for your practice, that enhance your practice. Okay. Mr. Divesh, will you please hold for a while your inquiry? Mr. Divesh Kumar, it's a request for you. Will you please hold your inquiry here? Once I conclude the class, for a while your chat will be open. There you can please communicate the same. Okay. Because it is getting diverted. Guys, if anybody wants to reach me on the GradeUp app, you can post your doubt and you can tag. Tagging means you just type after your doubt or at in front of the doubt. @SatyaNarayana. @SatyaNarayana, whenever you type, that will directly be routed to my inbox. Okay. Guys, I am sorry to tell this. The session is misleading. I understand you people are interested in green card, you people are interested in taking the NEELIT course. I am also very happy for that. But upfront, we have to learn the subject. Definitely, there will be buffer time. There we will discuss about the other things. However, our team is continuously monitoring it. Our team will continuously will give you support regarding your green card or course issues. So for a while, guys, concentrate on the class, please. It's a humble request. So let us suppose there is a 256 megabyte RAM, one block size is 1 MB, and there are 8 words in a block. In the same way, let us suppose 16 MB cache memory. Let us suppose there is 16 MB cache memory. Okay, so as one block size is 1 MB, there will be 256 blocks. Numbered from 0 to 255, and in the cache there will be 16 blocks. Numbered from 0 to 15. Right, now let's say there is a word X in block 2 that is copied, for X already misoccurred. And guys, listen carefully. In the miss, when any data is accessed for the first time, definitely miss occurs. That miss is what we call as compulsory miss. Because its occurrence is mandatory. Right. Now, when some data X is copied or some data I is copied into the cache memory, how the location is decided means, so location of X in cache memory, here C means cache memory, is decided as K modulus N block. What is K here? K is main memory block number, and N is number of cache blocks. Right? So, if block 2 is copied, because we know even if word X is requested, whole block gets copied into the cache all the time. So, what is the location of X in cache memory here? 2 modulus 16. 2 is the main memory block number, 16 is number of cache blocks. So that would be block 2. So that X as it is gets copied here. Similarly, suppose there is a request for Y. Compulsory miss occurred. Now, why? Let us suppose it is in 142 block in the main memory. So, how to find the location of Y in cache memory? 142 modulus 16. Right? So, this would be block 14, we know modulus gives reminder. So in the block 14, that y gets copied as it is. This complete block is copied here. This x is copied here. Okay. Now let us say there is a block. Guys, carefully listen. There is one more data at a block number 248. Block number 248, there is some data P. For P, compulsory miss occurred. So locality of reference suggests to copy all the block. So how the location of P is decided? That becomes 248. Wait a minute. Let's say 242. Okay, so location of P will be 242 modulus 16. This will be giving again block 2. So this P also mapped to block 2. That means now all the X block gets replaced by P block. Okay, someone was asking, I think. Manoj Upadhyaya, please focus now. So if X and P are needed by processor, after compulsory miss only, second time if X and P are needed by processor for the same instruction, can cache supply both? You tell me, guys. Can cache supply both? No, right? If X is supplied, P cannot be. If P is supplied, X cannot be. So for either hit occurs, for the other miss occurs. So only one can be hit, the other is miss. So this miss is what we call as conflict miss. This kind of miss is what we call as conflict miss. Got it? So how the cache direct mapped cache memory decides? We are talking about direct mapping, guys, don't forget that. How a direct mapped cache memory decides the place, the location for any block means using K mod N formula. Now, CPU always generates main memory address. CPU always generates main memory address. But this address should be understood by cache memory. And it should verify from that address cache copied it or not. Even if it is copied, there is no guarantee that it is there. So it has to verify, does it exist now or not, then it should generate hit, right? So CPU generate main memory address, but this address should be interpreted by cache memory. So how DM cache interpret it? Tag line offset and word offset. Suppose this is the main memory. Okay, so on. Let 256 blocks are there, 8 words are there, 8 words per block are there. And remember, the memory is word addressable. So how many bit address CPU generate? Word addressable means one word, one address. So what are total words we have? Total words is 256 blocks. In every block there are 8 words. So there are total 2 power 11 words. So for this example, this would be, the total would be 11 bits. As there are 2 power 11 words, 11 bit address it would be. Okay, in this, what is a tag means? What is tag means? DM cache assumes or understands or interprets main memory as group of cache memories. Groups of cache memories. Such group is termed as page. Sai, this page is different, that page is virtual memory page is different. Okay, here also the term is page. Like there are 256 blocks in main memory. There are 256 blocks in main memory, right? Now it is page 1, so on to page 7. Now what is tag means? Tag is equal to page number. Tag is what? Page number. Then what is line offset? Line offset indicates number of lines. Lines means what? It is another name, another term for blocks. Line is another term, another name for block. And then word offset indicates what? Block size. So tag means the page number. Line offset is number of lines in cache memory. By the way, in cache memory. And word offset indicates block size. Okay. Hello Pooja, and if the video gets stuck, please refresh it, guys. Please refresh it. But what is the drawback with this what is the drawback with this cache mapping technique, guys? That is, conflict misses are very high. Why? Because for block 2 of main memory, 2 modulus 16 gives cache block 2 only. For block 18 also, cache block 2 only. For block 34 also, cache block 2. Like this, you have seen block 242 also, it is block 2 in the cache only. So, multiple main memory blocks will be mapped to same cache block. So, whatever is replaced, if that is requested by the CPU, miss occur, that is called conflict miss. In this way, many miss occur. That's why we have got an alternate associative mapping technique. In the associative mapping, the block copied from main memory can be placed in any free block in cache memory. So in associative mapping, there is no such restriction. You can place in any free block. Okay? And in associative mapping, how the CPU address is interpreted? As just tag and word offset. Just as tag and word offset. Okay? What is tag? Here tag means main memory block number. In that block, word number. Word offset means. And here associative mapping will not interpret main memory as group of pages. It is just as group of 256 blocks only. But if it is a DM cache, it is interpreting the main memory as groups of 16 blocks. So, all together there are some 16, 256 by 16. 16 pages are there, right? That page number is maintained by DM tag, whereas CPU will not associative memory will not interpret like this. It will directly maintain from which block number I have copied as a tag. Okay, now what is the difficulty with set associative mapping means? Whenever CPU generate the address, which address? Main memory address. Cache has to interpret that address and find in itself for availability, whether that is available or not. The time taken for this producing hit or miss, that means to reply to CPU whether cache has the data or not, that time is what we call as hit latency or hit delay. Hit latency or hit delay. So what is the drawback of associative mapping? Means hit latency is high. Why it is high? Because it is maintaining main memory block number as stack. Will any main memory block number is duplicate? No. So it has to do all comparisons. But if you take direct mapping, every 16 blocks are sharing the same page number. So there are less page numbers. In fact, DM maintain same page number every time. So I don't discuss about that much because currently time will not be sufficient. So associative mapping takes more time for this comparison. That's why we have got set associative mapping. In the set associative mapping, cache group multiple blocks as set. So for your understanding, let me write like this. Suppose this is the cache memory. With 16 blocks. 4 blocks are grouped. So there are 4 sets. Okay. Block numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13, 14, 15. And now, how the placement happens? Suppose this is the RAM. As usual, let us take X from block 2. So, location of X in set associative cache, how it is measured? It is also measured with the formula K modulus N, but it will give you set number. So here K means same main memory block number, but N means number of sets. So guys, can you hear me? Just there is a power issue here. Fine guys, just I might not be visible properly, but I think I think my voice is clear for you. Okay. Right. Now, how to find the location of X in SAM? This is 2 modulus number of sets, that is 2, 4, so it would be in set 2. Now the point is, in set 2, there are 4 blocks, right? In set 2, there are 4 blocks. So, in which block to copy? In any free block. Any free block. So, like direct map, set is fixed. Like associative, in that set, any free block. So, we can say set associative mapping is the combination of DM and AM. DM means direct mapping, associative mapping means AM. Okay? Now, how CPU generated address is interpreted? CPU generated address is interpreted as, how it will be interpreted? As tag set offset and word offset. Tag set offset and word offset. So here set, we can know this indicates number of sets in the cache. Word, block size or number of, okay. So here we can say hit latency is less and conflict misses are also less, because every time replacement will not happen. Every time replacement will not happen, but replacement happens. When the set is full, then replacement happens. So the probability of conflict miss compared with DM, they are less, and hit latency is also less. That's why we can say SAM is efficient mapping technique. Out of all these three, and SAM is always represented as I-way SAM, where I represents number of blocks per set. Number of blocks per set. Okay. So this is what the thing. So to conclude, we have direct mapping cache, which interpret the address as tag, line and word. And it will place in K mod N cache block. The drawback is conflict misses are high. And when we take associative mapping, the interpretation of the same address would be tag and word. It can place in any block, any free block. Here, hit latency is high. And when you take set associative mapping, Its interpretation is tag, set and word offset. Here we will place in k mod n set any free block. Here conflict misses are less, hit latency conflict misses and hit latency both are less. Okay, so that's all for today guys. In the next class we would discuss about direct memory access, direct memory access. So whatever you have understood today, this will help you to solve cache memory problems. Okay, and guys, as many of you know or somebody might not, we have launched the paid course for this Nailit. If you want more examples, more detailed explanation of this topic or this kind of topics, all the syllabus would be covered in our course, and these are the expert faculty who will teach you. And the highlights of the course would be 300 plus hours of live classes will be there, 2600 plus practice questions, study notes, mind maps, full length mock tests, daily tests, weekly test, subject wise test. So these many we are providing, and the fee is, actual fee is 12,999, but there is an early bird discount, 50% off. That is, for 6,499 you will get up to 27th April if you enroll. And if you are GATE qualified, you will get additional 10% discount. That is, 5,199 would be the price for you, I mean GATE qualified students. Okay, so if you want more detailed explanation, more problems, all the syllabus coverage, please enroll for our course. And GATE qualified students, if you want to avail this extra discount, you may call on this number 965005290 or help@gradeup.co, anand.pandey@gradeup.co, you may mail. Okay, so that's all for today guys. Thank you so much for joining the session. Prep smart, score better, go GradeUp. Thank you.